Our journey began with a launch at the Motorsport Hall of Fame evening at the Roundhouse in London. A chance to show and tell the great and the good of the motorsport world about our ambitions for the challenge ahead.
I'm really looking forward to going back to Le Mans. The race has tended to clash with the Canadian Grand Prix in recent years, which has stopped me from being there. But this chance with Alex to go and race with the Nissan Zytec car is something I couldn't resist.
The dynamic between us is changed ever so slightly in that I'm pushing all the time and so is he for the best result possible. The be all and end all is winning Le Mans, and that's what I'm here to do.
One of the foundations of our Le Mans programme is making a seat that all three drivers are comfortable in so we can control the car and not get high spots and pain through the race. But of course, we're different sizes. Now, Vaughan Cartwright here has got a system which helps us achieve that. Vaughan, how on earth do you turn a bag of polystyrene balls into a Le Mans seat?
Yeah, it's quite a time-consuming process, Martin. This system allows us to achieve that by working on a vacuum process. So by literally taking all the air out of the bag, we're effectively moulding the seat around you.
It's just got a bit of give as well, hasn't it? So if we have a big shunt, there's a tiny bit of shock absorption for us.
The pedals and the steering wheel is what we can't change. We can adjust your sitting position to suit the pedals and the steering wheel.
You talk about antibacterial linings. I've never done it, but some drivers pee in the car I hear.
I've heard stories about it. Unfortunately, I've never had to deal with it either. But yeah, I mean, that's one aspect of obviously an advantage, but equally also from driver sweat, especially in a Le Mans car. You know, it's 24 hours of constant pressure, so to have some sort of additional aspect that can try and alleviate some of that is obviously an advantage.
So, very simple but incredibly effective, and this has to keep us in place. We're pulling 3.5G through the Porsche curves, for example, and lots of energy going on around the racetrack, and we're kept in place by a bag of these.
This is the first official test of the European Le Mans Series, and we're here preparing the car, preparing ourselves for the European Le Mans Series and also the Le Mans 24 Hours. Today we have our Le Mans 24 Hour drivers, me, Lucas Ordinaires and my dad in the car. It's nice. I mean, I'd like to think that we share information as two professional drivers would, and I'd like to carry that to continue. It's not really a father passing to son anymore. It's a to and a fro, and you know, both delivering the information that we feel relevant.
We're just going to have a quick 15 minutes in the car, hopefully before the lunch break. Then it'll give me a chance to just try to see, get a feel for an LMP2 car. And any changes we need so we don't lose any time this afternoon. I can get out and get straight on the program.
He's acclimatising really well. He's in the car pounding around as we speak, actually, and he's done an hour so far today, and hopefully a little bit more running now as we carry on into the afternoon. So, you know, he just needs a bit of time and he'll be bang up to speed.
If you're comfortable, if there's no problem, I'll let you do five and then shout you out for about two.
I think I was trying to drive it as if it was a new tyre like the one I had before. I was just asking too much about making mistakes and really struggling to keep hold of the car.
So, first test over 25 laps or something. It was good. I enjoyed it. A little bit rusty. Not really flowing with the car, braking a bit too hard, then you overslow the car, then you get on the throttle too hard, and just that being a bit clumsy with the car, really. So I would say I've got to sharpen up on a few areas and double my gym. And just remind myself about how to drive like a professional driver instead of somebody just jumping in and, you know, pressing the pedals too hard. You've got to be fluid with the car, and I wasn't doing that really, but I think it wasn't too shabby a time, really. I'm right in the hammer with that.